I think that's the most enjoyable part about this whole memorabilia thing is the warmth that the fans are giving us. I mean, it's all very well to be seen on screen, but to meet the people that make you feel good, that's a bonus, I think.
This film means so much to so many generations of people now across the world. Why do you think it has such a special resonance for so many different people?
My first thought on it has always been that it's for children, and it's aimed at children, and it's cast with a lot of children. Some of the key parts are children, so they feel it belongs to them. And that it really makes it their show to put on when they want to at school, and there are so many parts to play. I think it's broken the chain of being a short run or a long run and then no more, which is what happens with most musicals. This one's just gone on and on. It's very, I wish I was on a royalty. Somebody's getting it.
The musical is much beloved, but I think particularly your performance, your character, is one of the most iconic in cinema in many respects. Why do you feel he is a character that, you know, people identify and latch onto so much amongst all of the many wonderful elements of the film as a whole?
I think maybe to pin it down to the smallest area, it's because he's malevolently naughty. He's a really naughty man. Worse than the kids, they're naughty enough, but he teaches them to be naughty. And I think that, as simple as that, is probably the reason why it's so acceptable and, you know, keeps going on. Just when you think it's not going to be done anymore, Cameron Mackintosh brings it out again. And then in America, I think the film is shown every Christmas. Used to be shown every Christmas in England. You've got me sitting here answering your questions, and you expect me to talk about the other actors?
No, just your name and your character, thank you.
Yes, they're brilliant. They're marvellous, I love them. Now, back to me.
You're such a charming and nice man. I'm wondering how you got into the character of such a despicably naughty man as Fagin.
By making him as evil as they come, but charming and nice. You hit on it yourself, sir. And I agree.
Fans of the film have their own favourite moments. Are there any in particular that you're especially excited to see or especially fond of when you look back on?
Yeah, I've got a very favourite moment, which is pictured. I think that's a fantastic photograph, and it's got the two key characters who are two mischievous characters. He's as bad as him. I think that's a beautiful composition, and also the secret strength of Carol Reed is his these cobblestones. In The Third Man, Carol Reed used cobblestones, and I remember when they were wet cobblestones. And when we came to do this scene, the props were going around with buckets, dashing the water all over the cobblestones. And I said, that's it! Carol Reed is back again. And it's a marvellous symbol of Europe, really, the whole of Europe. Wet cobblestones. You can quote me on that.
What, looking back over your astonishing career, would you say you're most proud of outside of Oliver? Are there any other productions you've been involved with that you just look back on and think that was special as well?
Yeah, I suppose you could pick out different ones over the years. One of my favourites was a television half-hour play called Is That Your Body, Boy? Which was about this gym instructor and the way he handled these boys who were naughty. And I think I just hit strength in that. It's one of the things I'm most proud of. excellent script and a great joy to play.
It's been a great joy to talk to you today, sir. You are the master of naughtiness. And my very final question, do you have a message to your many fans watching this all around the world, particularly people who've grown up and will continue to love Oliver for many years to come?
Yeah, what about it?
Do you have a message to them? Would you like to say anything to them, to all those people?
I wonder what you were talking about, actually. But all my fans all over the world, I see you all in the distance through the fog of memory. But there you are, my fans. I speak to you now, as before, as never.
Thank you, sir. It genuinely has been an absolute honor.